Hello guys, welcome to this video. We are going to see here how to create a nice 3D logo like this one in a very few and easy steps. To watch this video, make sure to know the basics of this software. In case you need help, further annotations will help you at getting more help. As you may know, a logo is very important. It will be your personal signature and will represent your future projects. Before going on, you need to think about it carefully. What kind of name must have? What kind of text? And, especially, what kind of symbol or image must have? Designing this may be complex and take a lot of time. You must have in mind a general idea of how to create your logo before going on. This is an example of a simple logo. Logos are usually simple in 2D or 3D. Make sure to use a simple name, easy to be remembered, and shapes not too much complex. Simple logos are the easiest ones to be remembered. To start creating your first logo, it is fundamental to know how to use the pen tool. To know how to use the pen tool, watch the related video in this show. In this tutorial, I will show you how to create this kind of logo. However, I will present here a rough of what you could do. Mind that, at each step, it will take a longer time to create the logo at its best. You can freely download the .ai project through the video description. The project presented there will be better designed. However, our case is to draw a pseudosphere, so a very easy shape. How to create it? First of all, we need to draw the basic 2D shape from which the 3D is built. The 3D effect is created selecting a 2D shape and going to Effect and then to 3D. There are three ways to create a 3D shape, but the best one is the revolve one. In short, the 2D shape built, a closed or not path, is used as a basic section to create a full symmetric 3D shape. Its color is the stroke color of the 2D basic shape. So, with the pen tool, it's enough to create three anchors, using the intermediate one to create a semicircumference, perfect or not. If we want the 3D shape to be blue, its stroke must be blue. Then we simply make it in 3D. Go to Effects, 3D and then to Revolve. A new window lets you manage all. Drag the cube sample to change the point of view. Make sure to check preview in the bottom left corner or you won't see anything rendered live. Interesting are the light options inside the More Options button. Here you can set the light you like most. Then just go to OK. You will obtain a brilliant 3D shape. You can edit it anytime, selecting the object from Layers window and go to Appearance. If you want to know more about 3D objects in Illustrator CC, watch the related video in this show. Let's suppose that this is a plastic ball and we want some metal strips on it. This simply makes stronger the 3D effect and makes the logo better to be watched. Activate again the pen tool and create random strips on the sphere. Fundamental is to respect its edges and its shape, so zoom in if you need. Put no stroke and don't be worried about the filling. To give a metal effect, we can simply use a gradient. Go to Window and then to Gradient. Then select each strip and click on the gradient bar. For a metal effect, we need to put a gray color smooth with white where we want the light reflection. At this point, the 3D is present, but it's not realistic. So we can put some extra fade in the opposite side of the light. Let's create another object with the pen tool on the other side and put a flat solid color with a low opacity that you can set through the appearance window. We can put extra fade using a gradient through the whole sphere, playing with the gradient window then. If you're not satisfied with the illumination set by default, we can create one on our own. Hide the metal strips and use the pen tool to draw a new area with the same filling color of the sphere. Don't worry if the colors may be different. Then just activate the gradient and use a radial one. You can put any color you like on the center. This will be the color of the reflected light. To be integrated with the shadow effect, make sure to place this object lower than the shadow object in the layers order. Again, don't be worried if the colors don't match properly. Now set again the strips on and see if the effect is satisfactory. Remember to put the reflection below the strips through the layers window. It is better if you observe your project when it is small, since logos usually don't occupy a full page as when working on it. The sphere created really does seem in 3D now. Not to modify it in the future, lock the full layer 1. Next to the eye, a square is shown besides layer 1. If you click on it, you will lock all the layer and so you won't edit all its objects inside, unless you unlock the layer again. At this point, it is convenient to create new layers for each complex object we will have. We can complete this logo adding some shadow and/or reflection. To add reflections, just unlock layer 1, hold the control down and drag the selection area to select your wall layer, and then copy it in full using Ctrl and C. Create a new layer in the Layers window and be sure to have it selected. Then you can paste the copy. The copy will belong to the new layer. Go in the new layer and make sure to have locked the basic sphere. If you don't do this, the 3D shape will be compromised after the next step. With the wall logo selected, click on Object and go to Transform. Select Reflect. You have several options you can try. In our case, we just need to flip horizontally. So just choose Horizontal. Click Preview to see if the transformation is correct. You may need to correct the imperfections of the strips, and also the default reflection may be wrong. So just set it again, unlocking the basic sphere, and go into Appearance. Then select a move all right below the original sphere. Now we just need to put a very deep feather. The fastest way is to use a rectangle with white filling and with some transparency when close to the sphere. Then lock this other layer. Another idea could be choosing to add shadow. This is way easier since you just need to add an ellipse. Then just put a radial gradient and you will make it. Remember to put the shadow in a lower position, below the sphere. Now just the text is missing. You must have in mind the name you want to put in, and the font to use. In this phase, many solutions are possible. Just use one that does fit with the logo created, in color and style. You can personalize your text even more. Select the text through the Layers window, then go to Type and then to Create Outlines. The text will be treated as an object drawn through the Pen tool, so you can adjust the paths and personalize them. This simple project, seen with a certain distance, gives out a very nice 3D shape, made in a very short time too. Now try to create your first logo, download in the video description the .ai project file so that you can see better how it has been composed. Thanks for watching.